Taking the time to come over to this special event. Thank you, ladies, so much for participating in our Women of the Earth panel.
And I know you're supposed to be hosting this thing, but can I just interrupt for 1 second? So Patrick just said it sounds like he had a crazy night last night. And the reason I'm wearing these glasses is not because I also had a crazy night, which I wish I did. I actually just got laser surgery a couple weeks ago, so my eyes are still healing. I'm not pulling a Hollywood on you. In fact, I'll show you right now. They're just a little bit red. All right,
now we're very concerned that everyone might think she's being a diva.
Yeah, I was.
I want you to know from the outset, obviously.
I mean, I do have a little bit of diva in here, let's not lie. But not this much.
Great. So, ladies, I sent them all prepared questions, and I'm not going to ask any of those.
No.
I knew it.
I'm going to throw questions out at these ladies, and we're just going to freewheel it, and we're going to have opportunity at the end for you to ask questions yourselves. I'm hoping there's some people here today who would like to get into fishing and hunting who may not be, especially women. And we're hoping that these ladies will prove to be great role models for people such as you and you. So I'm going to throw this question out. I'm going to start with Mariko. Who first got you interested in fishing?
Well, it was definitely my family. My uncle and my dad have had a sport fishing show for my entire life. Literally, the year I was born was the year that they started their own TV show to do with fishing. So I just grew up on the water, mostly bass fishing. And on the weekends, instead of going to summer camp, I was traveling with my family, my mom included, who's right in the audience there, little cutie. We were traveling to fishing tournaments, from fishing tournament to fishing tournament to fishing tournament. So that's how it kind of started. And then I went through a big phase where I was off in Europe and school and stuff, and didn't think I was going to follow in her footsteps at all. But a few things led to all of this, and now here I am.
There's Daddy Wayne there.
Oh, there's Wayne.
Yes.
He's right now in the Amazon fishing for peacock bass, so I'm a little bit jealous right now.
So, if you didn't know already by Mariko's last name, she comes with a bit of a fishing pedigree. Her dad, Wayne, is the brother of Bob Izumi, and as everyone knows, hosts of Real Fishing TV show. Amanda.
Yes.
You found me?
Yes, I am. I was Vanessa this morning.
Who's that?
That is my grandmother. And she shot that moose in 1960. And that gun is still in the family. That's the gun that I use to go moose hunting and bear hunting with. That was very cool. I'm so proud of that.
So obviously hunting is
definitely in the family.
Family and tradition and been a long time. So you had no choice but to become a hunter.
Yeah, and the same with Mariko. I was in the bush, raised around it, partridge hunting with my dad, fishing and all that. And then backed away from it for a few years and then came into it again about 10 years ago, and here I am.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And Kathryn, how did you get caught up in this crazy thing called fly fishing?
Well, I grew up a long time ago, before there were cars, and
on
the east coast of Canada, at a time when the boys went fishing, and I have an older brother and a younger brother, and my dad would take my brothers fishing, and I wasn't invited because I was a girl. So I always wanted to be with my dad, and it made a big impression on me, so my next door neighbor, we lived on the water. He taught me how to fish. I would sneak out in the morning before school I thought if I got really good, then my dad would invite me. My brothers would come back with secret handshakes and whisper all these stories, and I wanted to be part of that. But sadly, I was never invited, and I can outfish them today. Woo!
Now, there's a classic example, which we'll get into the issue later, of because of your sex, you were automatically not involved in fishing and hunting.
Yes.
And
the boys took out the garbage, the girls did the dishes.
Yes.
I think it's a different time now.
Yes.
Yes, different time. Yeah.
Which is great. And I know, speaking from experience, because my firstborn was a girl, that if I wanted to keep going afield, fishing, hunting, I had to take a kid with me. So, consequently, yes, my firstborn was catching bass on a topwater by the time she was six. So, yeah. Vanessa, did you get going on this?
I was actually a late bloomer. I didn't get involved with hunting and fishing until about 7 years ago. All started about a whirlwind. Went out with a friend to sight in some rifles, and I had such an amount of fun. I was like, okay, I've got to try hunting. What's the next step? And he was like, well, I'm not taking you anywhere until you get your hunting
license. I think we're still working on that feedback.
Until you get your hunting education. Once you get your hunting education, then I'm going to take you hunting. And I was like, okay, cool. So next thing I know, I get past the test and everything. He hands me a plane ticket to the Northwest Territories, and I'm going Central Barren Ground Caribou hunting. So my very, very first animal ever killed was this.
And that's TJ. TJ Schwanke is one of our field editors. Vanessa's better half, or other half, shall we say. So that's how we get to know Vanessa. Ladies, aside from the tradition and you growing up with it or coming into it later in life, what is it about fishing and or hunting that appeals to you? Why do you fish and hunt? Let's start with Kathryn.
It's the places that it takes you. It's where it takes you physically into these beautiful areas, but where it takes you emotionally as well. And you get in touch with that little voice again that in the big city gets drowned out at times. And it's being close to nature and the wonders and the mystery of what unfolds. Every time you go out, it's a different experience. And you really get to communicate. You know, the cell phones are shut off, you're not on your computer. And I think it's really living life. It's building the stories of our lives and gathering memories, so that's what it is for me. But I also like to catch a big Jesus fish.
It likes me, you said.
Don't we all?
Yeah.
Mariko.
I mean, everything that Kathryn just said, for sure. Some of my best memories have been on the water, especially the past 3 years. Another thing I love about it is the thing that gets me to my most calm point. I do all sorts of other stuff, including hot yoga. And when I'm in that hot yoga studio, I'm pretty clear and I'm pretty focused and I'm feeling pretty zen. But actually when I'm on the water is when I'm the most zen. There's something about being on the water, no matter what type of fishing I'm doing. I'm just focusing on the beautiful landscape in front of me and whatever I'm doing. And my mind's not going, you know, a million miles per minute, which it normally is. So for me, it's almost therapeutic, which I think is, you know, a really healthy thing.
Vanessa, I see you shaking your head.
I'm actually in agreement with both of these ladies. I mean, you know, going out in the outdoors, the things that I experience, I do a lot of mountain hunting. And so you're climbing a mountain in the dark, and you get to the top of the mountain, and then you experience the most amazing sunrise. It's absolutely breathtaking. You go out and you're experiencing wildlife and the behaviors and just what nature can hand to you. It's just amazing. And then, you know, when I get the opportunity to travel to places like Africa and New Zealand and various other places, and unlike the average person who gets to go and travel and they're just a tourist, right? We actually go into people's homes. You're experiencing the actual local culture. You really get to experience their life and the true Africa or true New Zealand, and you're experiencing and you're meshing into their lives, and that is just a part, a great part of being a part of the outdoors.
Yeah, Vanessa makes a really good point.